Welcome to this brief guide on how to insert stock images in PowerPoint. If you've been working on your presentation but struggle to find the right image to insert into your slide deck, then today I'm going to make life a lot easier for you using a feature that's found natively in PowerPoint. Here you can see I happen to have a presentation that I'm working on called Punk in the Park, all about an upcoming punk concert in the local park. However, I want to insert a bit of a cartoon image into my slide. Normally, I would use the Draw tab and select the pen icon, and if I had something like a Surface Pen, I could maybe draw better here, but drawing with a mouse is difficult. And to be fair, I can't really draw anyway. So instead, I'd love to be able to just quickly insert some cartoon characters. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to delete that image out of there, and I'm going to use a feature built into PowerPoint for stock imagery. In order to get there, I need to select the Insert tab in my ribbon, and about a third of the way along, we have options in Illustrations, and we're going to select the option that says Icons. Selecting this will open up a pop-up over the top of our presentation window, and you can see that we currently have some icons that we could search through, and we can select any of these and insert them into our presentation. But what you'll notice at the top is that we have different categories that we can select from for our stock images. I'm going to select the Cartoon People option, as that's what I want to insert into my presentation. Here you can see we have a selection of images, but this doesn't look like there's a lot. But if we were to scroll down a little bit, we'll have some subcategories that we can select from, and you'll see that we have options such as heads, faces, upper body, and more. And so here you can see I've selected the heads option, and I have a wide selection of heads to choose from. I'm going to select the guy with a bit of a mohawk. And then what I can easily do as well is then jump over to the faces category, and then I can choose to select the face that I would like my character to have. And the reason is because I can select multiple components all at once to be able to insert easily at the same time. Maybe I need to get a bit of a body for my character, so I'm going to select from the full body options here. And as you can see, we have characters on bikes, characters with walking sticks. We even have someone with a cape, so I think someone with a cape looks pretty cool. So we're going to select that option. And then we can jump over to accessories, and we have options for hats, facial hair, glasses, face masks. You name it, we've pretty much got it all. I'm going to select a lovely little thin mustache for my punk rocker, and then we're going to jump over to the option for scenes, and this will give me some different backgrounds that I could look to put my character into. And as you can see, we've got options for workspaces, houses, and let's go with the trees surrounding the crossing. We'll pretend we're going to go with a bit of an Abbey Road look. And then I can select the insert button in the bottom corner here, and this will insert all of my images all in one go. And now all that's really left is for me to arrange them to make my image make sense. So here I'm going to click away so that I can move individual images. And now I'm going to move my character's head, attach it to the body that we inserted as well. Let's grab that facial expression. And one of the things that makes it really easy to do this is the lovely little smart guides built into PowerPoint. And here you can see I can easily attach that mustache and make sure it sits in the right spot. And now I've got my character ready to go. Now the last thing I would generally recommend doing here as well, so that I can resize my image, is holding down Shift and selecting all of the different elements on my slide there, and then using the group function in PowerPoint in order to group them all into one image. And then I can simply use the corners and hold down Shift, and I can resize it whilst maintaining the aspect ratio, and there I have my lovely little cartoon image of a punk rocker standing in the middle of the crossing wearing his cape. And whilst I've been able to quickly and easily insert my cartoon character, don't forget that you have access to icons, stickers, images, and more all through the stock images feature in PowerPoint. I hope you found this tip extremely useful, and it saves you plenty of time with your next presentation, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.